My name is Dee Paredes, and my family's here today. My daughter, my great-granddaughter, and my son-in-law. He might not want you to bring me up. No. I'm from Hampton, Iowa, originally. Grew up there. In the summers, my mother would go to where my dad was in the Army, and we would stay with my grandparents, and they made sure we went to church. They were good, strong Baptist people. And I don't remember much about my dad. He was in the service until I was about 8 or 9. And my mother would take us to church. And then when I got married at 16 and my husband was 17. And to make it even worse, he was Mexican. And at that time in a small town, it was very hard. Everybody said the marriage wouldn't last. It only lasted 56 years. We have 3 children who all have gone to college and are very successful. Amen. Amen. Our church closed in the 60s because of financial reasons, and we just kind of fell away from the church at that time. My husband got cancer in 2006, and for 3 years was very sick, and I took care of him at home. He died in 2009, and I just stayed in Hampton. And then last year, my granddaughter wanted to open a daycare, and my son-in-law and her talked about it, and he had the finances to back her, so she opened a big daycare on Shurfine across from Cisco, and they decided to move here. So I told them I would move here with them. They didn't want me to stay there alone. And they had planned on moving in the fall. And I said, well, I'm going to move now. And that was in April. And they said, no, there's no hurry. But something made me come. I just thought my granddaughter needed me. She needed help. So I kind of just went against their wishes, and my other son helped me move, and I moved into the HEPA in May. And she did need help. I went over and helped clean and did the dishes and cooked, and she just started in June, and now she has 150-some children, and it's still growing. And my son-in-law is getting tired of driving back and forth. But after I was here, while I was sitting out in front with one of the ladies, and I said, well, I can't wait to go to heaven to see my husband. And she says, oh, you won't see him right away. And I said, well, yes, the Bible says I will. And she says, no, when you die, your body stays in the ground. And when Jesus comes again, then he'll rise you. I was just so upset. I just told her I had to go upstairs, and I went upstairs, and I thought about it all night, and went to work the next day and thought about it. And Janice had told me about this church, and I just couldn't take it anymore. I got in my car and cried all the way over here. And the deacons were all out to lunch, naturally. So I sat in the office and waited. And while I was waiting, she said she would give me the first minister that came, and it was Chuck. And I'm so thankful for Chuck. We went into one of the rooms, and I told him why I was upset. And he said, Dee, do you remember the verse where Jesus was on the cross, and one of the murderers was confessing to him, and he said to the murderer, I will meet you today in paradise. And boy, did I have a heavy lift off of me. I thought, I will see him. And then the more we talked, I decided, and we both decided, that I needed some Bible studying. So I came every Monday and studied with Chuck. And on August 16th, I don't know why, I was real melancholy and came to my lesson. And anyhow, Chuck said to me, "Dee, are you ready to accept Christ?" And I said, "I'm more than ready." So we prayed, and I felt so good and just a relief over me. And then he brought me out into the office, and there were four young men there, and Pastor Pat, and they all said a prayer for me, and I got four hugs. That was the best part. So anyhow, I do accept Christ. Amen. And I used to go to church all the time, and I thought I was a Christian until I started studying. And I learned it's not what I want. It's what Christ wants. And I'm so happy for that. That I know that, so now I can relax because I know I will go to heaven now.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Let's just pray for Dee. Father, we just thank you for your powerful work in Dee's life. And Father, for the salvation that she came to know. And Father, we pray that she would continue to grow in her understanding and that she would be a great light for you and in this world. Thank you so much for Dee. In Jesus' name, amen. Step this way just a little bit. Dee, based on your testimony in the Lord Jesus Christ and your faith in him, I baptize you now in the name of the Father and the Son and in the Holy Spirit.